Keurig going in the back now to wake y'all asses up. So, and the coffee going, so we can start doing that. But how y'all been? You guys enjoying your weekend? Labor Day's coming. Yeah, we get around boys, that's a weekend. Party on. Here's the shit. Alright, so I'm going right to this topic. Let's talk about kids, alright? You know, everyone, some have kids, some don't, some want them, some accidentally have them, some just whatever, they pop out. So, I'm coming to the conclusion that I know what I'm gonna do. Like, kids always want entertainment. I'm not gonna be able to fucking deal with it when the kids are like, Daddy, I wanna go to the playground. I wanna go to Six Flags. I wanna go to Six Flags. I ain't got money for that, dog. I'm fucking getting free pizza from a friend that works at the job. I ain't hooking it up. But back in the day, I remember going to Chuck E. Cheese and I realized I'm gonna do this shit. Like, my parents didn't raise me ghetto. Like, we weren't raising no ghetto shit, but it just comes with the skin. You just. Ghetto is in the blood. You just feeling it. It just triflingism finding a way. It just comes with it. I made that word up. Triflingism. Put it in the dictionary, Urban Dictionary, Wikipedia, shit. So, all right. My parents were chucking, taking Chuck E. Cheese all the time, and Chuck E. Cheese is fucking disgusting. Like, I don't understand. You got your fucking kid running around with a snot nose, picking his ass, playing fucking X-Men in the arcade and shit. Like, it just, it's disgusting. So, I remember when I used to go to Chuck E. Cheese. I used to be like, Dad. My dad's an angry Dominican person. I just went, Father, Dad. I don't know why I just said father. Who the fuck? Father, you buy me a pizza. Why did he buy me a pizza, first of all? This dude was like, hey, when we go to the fucking place, don't ask me for no pizza. Don't ask me no for what, no cold soda. You're not getting enough, you get water. When you go to the bathroom, you just sit in the sink. Yeah, just like that. That's what you want to fucking do. So I'm in there, and you always, when you go to Chuck E. Cheese, they just, you push to hang out with this fucking, the worst kid. It's not even like you can choose who you want to chew with. So there's always the one kid in the tube with the funky ass feet that's like, hey, how long you been here? Did you try the pizza? They're eating cake! I don't give a fuck, I'm gonna get the cake. But you know what? I found ways around this shit, loopholes. You guys go, you know, you chill with your kid, and you guys have no choice. Your kid's like, yeah, I like it! You gotta take it, but you just ordered a fucking pizza. Perfect, boom, sitting at the table. What do I do as soon as that pizza gets here? Steven, party of three! Party of three, they drop it, they don't give a fuck. What did I do? Shit. Swoop, slice, ran right through the fucking tubes, ate the shit out of that shit. That's what I'm gonna teach my kid to do. From now on, if you wanna get some free pizza, I'm not paying for it. You just go up there and swipe it. So I remember going up there and I would get the pizza, and I would chew the pizza, and I would be choking on it, just sitting in the tube, just, oh, God, doing as fast as I can. My mom would be like, Daddy, where are you? Eating pizza and shit. So, also, too, another loophole I had is, if you want to get a drink, how's it going, guys? Shout out to my friends. Let me get a handshake for them coming in. Anyway, all right. I realized, because of me, I think Chuck E. Cheese knows that loophole. Just like my mom found out with the Long Island iced teas here, won a ticket, boom, fucking drunk. Now two tickets, y'all. Sorry. Sorry about that. I don't know where that accent came from, but sorry about that. But I used to take the fucking coin cup. You go right to the Dr. Pim. Fill it up. It's a perfect shot. You can slam down six shots of Dr. Pim. Gone. Perfect. But now they put holes in the bottom of the shit. So it's fucking crazy. And I had a whole point, but I feel like I've been here so long that my brain just melted down into my body. I'm falling asleep almost, but I'm having a good time, and everyone's having a good time, so let's have a round of applause for that. Oh, that's a slap over there. All right. So I realized, the other day, I was getting ready to hang out with my girlfriend, and I just never have cologne. I'm always just either fucking just putting lotion on, just lotion the fuck up. Like, most people don't use lotion, right? Do I sound weird right now? Who uses lotion? Damn, I'm the only one. All right, the women do. I look like a bitch. So, I like the lotion up, but I remember one day I went riding with my friend. I ride BMX, obviously didn't wear the shirt, shout out to the bike ride. And one day I come home and my brother Jonathan is really, like I said, it comes with the skin, tries validity, keep it up. They're gonna make shirts, I'm gonna fucking rock with this. So he comes to me and I'm like, I don't have time to shower, dude. I'm gonna smell like shit, smell like balls, I smell like Icon, I'm gonna just spray Axe, I'm gonna Axe up. He goes, oh, what your problem is, I always just use baby wipes. I looked at him just like that, like, she's like, yeah, you just go back and wipe up. I'm not gonna get no pussy smelling like white asshole, Jonathan. What the fuck is your problem? And then I think about this shit, because I remember back in the days having friends in high school, after doing gym, I'm knocking shit down. Oh my god. I'm going to gym and everyone's baby wiping. Like, but who wants to smell like that? Like a white asshole. But you know what? That's my time. I hope you guys enjoy yourself. Get your drink on, get your party on. Enjoy yourself. Fucking back, Shoddy!
Keep it going, man. Thank you. All right, our next contestant on The Price is Right, Manny Urias.